to be astonished.
Now that we know all the methods for solving any quadratic equation, we can actually solve other equations, in other words, non-quadratic equations, by turning them into quadratic equations using a strategy called substitution. Okay, now take a look at this equation. It really doesn't look like a quadratic because you don't see the x squared, do you?
Allow me to demonstrate.
Okay, but with substitution, let's look at the middle term. We put things in descending order by their degree.
Welcome to Fantasy Island.
And let's let's introduce a variable s. I say s for substitution. It could have been any letter, but s. And let s be the middle term without a coefficient. Okay? And if we restate this equation in terms of s, well, if s is the square root of x, then x would be s squared.
I hate you.
Well, wait a minute. If s is the square root of x, then let's write this as minus s, or minus 1s. And the rest of it doesn't involve s, so we just write it the same way. And now you've got a quadratic equation that you are, of course, an expert in and can solve. Let's do it. This one is not that bad. We'll do it by factoring. Okay? So the answers to this equation are 3. That's what makes the first factor 0.
Certainly.
And negative 2. That's what makes the other factor 0. Okay, so you think we're doing pretty good, except
there's something wrong with us. Something very, very wrong with us.
I knew you were worried a little bit. Remember that we don't want the S. We want X. So if we're going to use this fancy substitution, we have one extra step, and that is we have to change the S's back into X's. And we have a magic conversion equation. Okay, that's the key. That's why I put that in a box. I always put my a substitution equation in a box because I know I'm coming back to it later. So if s equals the square root of x, we'll put in a 3 for s and solve it for x. Of course, we solve it by squaring both sides, and one of the answers will be that x is 9. The other s I got was a negative 2. So let's put that in for s and solve for x by, in this case, squaring both sides. And, son of a gun, we have two answers that will work for x as 9 and 4. Now let me do another one and see what we do with that's the same as we did the first time, okay? Once again, we don't have a quadratic equation here, do we? But our goal is to try and change it into a quadratic equation. Okay, I want you to always look at the middle term and a portion of that.
Now what am I going to do?
That portion without the coefficient. And that is what you're going to let s equal.
Welcome to Fantasy Island.
Okay, we're going to let s be that middle term without the coefficient. And then we'll substitute with the promise that it'll turn it into, hopefully, a quadratic equation. Let's take a look at it. If we restate this in terms of s, this term, if s is p squared, that term is s squared, isn't it? It's p squared squared. And this term, that's a little easier, is
excellent.
Minus 3s. And the rest of it doesn't involve P or S.
Don't leave me hanging.
So we just write it. Okay? Now, once we've turned it into a quadratic equation and we solve it. Now, all of these, I'll tell you right now, since we're trying to emphasize the point of substitution, we're going to make it so that you can solve all of them using factoring.
Gee, let me think.
Okay? So let's factor that. And get the two answers that are involved. One of them is 4, and the other is negative 1. And you think we're looking good.
You're way off. I say you're way off.
off this time, son.
Well, we're not that far off, except we've just forgotten that we have to convert back to the original letter P. And we have a key to doing that.
Warning! Warning! Warning!
Uh-oh, wait a minute. The other thing we need to worry about in this problem is that we should have four answers, shouldn't we? Because this is a degree of four. Well, let's see what happens. S equals P squared. That's our key conversion formula. So let's put in 4 for S into that formula. 4 for S now, and solve for P. Now how do we get P alone?
Now I use my secret weapon!
Now we're going to undo a squared with a square root. And remember, whenever we take a square root, we get two answers. So two of the answers are plus and minus 2. Now the other S that we got was negative 1. We'll put him in and solve for P. Now be careful here. If we take the square root of both sides,
not a lot.
We're going to get an imaginary number. This is a good review. The square root of negative 1 is an imaginary number, so we're going to get two other two answers are plus and minus I, plus and minus the square root of negative 1. So we have four answers.
I am a genius.
Plus and minus 2 and plus and minus I. Pretty cool, huh? I bet you could do one even more challenging.
Well, I suggest you gentlemen invent a way to put a square peg in a round hole. Rapidly.
Now be careful. Use the same method we did. Have some discipline here.
Now look at, I say look at here!
We have something squared minus something times that same factor. Okay, so we really do have three terms. And I told you, remember what I told you to use? The middle term without the coefficient. So we're going to let S equal...
Welcome to Fantasy Island.
Let S equal X minus 3. Doesn't matter whether I write the parentheses. And if I do that and restate this equation in terms of S, watch what I get. This will be... S squared. How sweet is that? The middle term will be minus 3s, won't it? And the rest of it, as usual,
don't leave me hanging,
will just come down. Okay? Now we'll solve this, what is now a quadratic equation. Much easier, isn't it? My mother could do this. Let's factor it. And the answers, two answers, are 4 and minus 1. Looking good.
The important thing is, this is your final answer.
Now, I'll tell you what, the most common mistake is people think they have two answers and they forget that they have to turn the answers back into the original variable using the conversion equation. Okay? So that's the conversion equation. S equals X minus 3. And let's put each of these answers that we got for S in for S. Okay, we should get two answers. Seems reasonable. Okay, so if 4 equals X minus 3, we can solve and get that X equals 7 is one of the answers. And we can solve the other one, putting minus 1 in for S, and get that...
Hasta la vista, baby.
Hey, this is great!
So the answers are 7 and 2. And look at the original equation. If you put them in, son of a gun, they do work. Okay? Almost too good to be true, isn't it?
No, I can't take it. I can't take it, Jerry! It's too much! It's too much!
We can do an even harder problem. Well, I'm hoping... by now, that you can look at this equation and already tell me what you're going to let S equal.
My poor little queen.
I'll help you out a little bit. Always the middle term without the coefficient. So S is going to equal...
Welcome to Fantasy Island.
4m minus 3. And if we restate it in terms of S, this term, what will that term equal? 2 times...
Three words. Fab-u...
Plus 2s squared. And this term will equal...
Well, ooh-la-dee-da.
And
could it be?
We'll just write the rest as we always do. Now, we can't factor this and use the zero property until we have a zero, recall. So let me subtract 5 from both sides.
Does everybody know what time it is?
Now it's time to factor, okay? And if we factor it, hopefully, once again this review, you can tell me what the two solutions for S are. Well, I can't do this one in my head. Let me solve it. I'll subtract 1 from both sides and divide by S. I'll divide by 2, and S is minus 1/2. The other one I can do in my head. S is 5. So I have two solutions for S. This time a fractional one. Don't be afraid. Minus 1/2 and 5. Well, there it is. Aren't we done? I think we're done, aren't we? Oh, no! Don't forget to turn the S back into M's, okay? On this side, we'll put in, instead of S, into the conversion equation, minus 1/2, and we'll have an equation with a fraction in it. I'll add 3 to both sides. Well, let's see. 3 minus 1/2 is 2 1/2. Now, how do I solve that?
I know you are, but what am I?
Well, 2 1/2 is 5/2. Okay, now I can solve it. I'm multiplying by 1/4. And this was a tough one, but M equals 5/8. On the other side, a little bit easier, if I put a 5 in for S, all I have to do is add 3 to both sides and then divide by 4, and M will be 2. And that's about as hard as it gets. That involved everything. So you have two answers, 5/8 and 2. That was a tough one, wasn't it? Okay?
Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Let's do one more substitution example. What are we going to let S be this time?
Poindexter?
Well, it's not going to be that bad. It's the same thing. If you think about it, it's the middle term without the coefficient. So S equals X to the 1/3. Now, it looks a little scary, doesn't it? But if you think about it,
welcome to Fantasy Island.
And we restate this. This term, X to the 2/3, is X to the 1/3 squared. So it could be written,
believe it or not,
S squared, couldn't it? And the middle term is just minus 5, minus 5s.
Don't let me hang.
And then just write the rest.
Ooh, yes.
This wasn't that bad, as long as you don't let these fractional exponents get you nervous. Now let's factor. And our two S answers are 3 and 2. Now, what do we have to do at the end? It's not wrong, it's just not finished. And how do we solve a problem with X to the 1/3? What are we going to have to do to both sides to get X by itself? Well, I'm going to, first of all, substitute my answer 3 in for S, and then I'll solve for X by
now I use my secret weapon.
Raising each side to the index of the root. X to the 1/3 is the cube root, so I'm going to raise it to the 3rd power, and it'll get X alone. And X in that case will be 27, because 3 to the 3rd is 27. With the other answer, instead of S, I'm going to put a 2, and I'm going to solve it the same way. I'm going to use the inverse of the cube root. I'm going to cube both sides. And the answer will be X is 8, because 2 times 2 times 2 is 8.
Boy, is this crazy!
How about that? Never thought you could have solved that original equation, did you? Well?
No, I can't take it. I can't take it, Jerry! It's too much! It's too much!
Well, you need to go do the homework and practice. You can see that most of them are just about the same thing, okay? So be looking for that middle term without the coefficient.